Hey there. I realized that I did not do an adequate job of explaining our decision to cease doing live streaming during our Sunday morning worship services. So I wanted to clarify that now so there wouldn't be any more misunderstanding. I've seen on social media that there have been some people discussing some of the things they felt like were the reasons, one of which was that it was extra work on our staff. I can assure you that was not the reason. It is extra work, particularly on Eric. I know some smaller churches don't have as much involvement in what it requires to do it with the quality we tried to do it. So it did require extra work, but Eric was certainly willing to do it. So that was not the reason. Another thing that was implied or communicated was that this was an opportunity to force people to come back to church. I don't see the Lord forcing us to do things. God is not a God who forces us, but gives us choices. So likewise, I do my best as a pastor to not manipulate, coerce, or force people to do things. Absolutely, I think it's imperative for the church to gather. I think that we need to gather for so many reasons. And I spent a good bit of time explaining this in a message I preached 4 weeks ago on the nature of the church. If you didn't see that, I would strongly encourage you to find it on the church app or on our webpage and view that message, because it lays a lot of the biblical undergirding for the decision that was made to suspend the live streaming. Now, of course, you need to know and you need to realize that the sermons are still available. We make them available. You can hear the teachings every week. We put them up on all the different platforms on Monday, so you can continue to hear the Word of God. We just have not placed the worship and the communion there. And there is a biblical reason for that. Jesus said that when two or three are gathered together in my midst, in my name, I'm there in the midst. The Apostle Paul talks about how when you're there and the Spirit of God is among you. So there is precedent from Scripture that something supernatural happens when the people of God gather to worship, to receive the Lord's Supper, to feast upon the Lord, that Jesus actually mediates his presence to us through the elements as we gather. The live streaming was a great accommodation while we were in lockdown, and also until people were able, if they so chose, to get vaccinated. But now that we don't have to be locked down, what we're doing is we're communicating by our practice that we believe the gathered church cannot be replicated through a video. It's just not the same. Now, that doesn't mean you can't listen to worship music on a Sunday morning. That doesn't mean you can stay at home and be blessed. It doesn't mean that you can't listen to one of my teachings that was released the previous week on a Sunday morning and receive encouragement and strength. Of course you can. But the reality is that Jesus does something in the gathered church that is not communicated or translated through a live stream. So I want to encourage you that if you haven't returned to church, we're not doing this to try to force you to do it. We're not being uncaring. This really is a matter of desiring to communicate accurately so that our polity, our practice, aligns with our theology or our belief. And that's what we're really attempting to do. Now, I know people disagree with this. I mean, there are scads of churches that are continuing to do it, and that's fine. That's between them and the Lord. But I believe for us, I'm doing what I know to do, and our leadership team to do what we know to do, to be integrous biblically, and yet still provide teaching for those who don't feel like they can come yet. Also, I want you to know that we do have one section in the sanctuary, in the worship center, where masks will be required and people will still social distance. That's not required throughout the sanctuary. It's one small section only for those people who want to continue to socially distance and wear masks, that they will have a place where other people will be doing the same. 70% of the sanctuary will not be that way. Everyone will be together without the social distancing, but that option is available. So regardless of where you stand on all these issues, I felt it imperative that you hear my heart and know what our desire was going forward. So let me pray with you. Lord, I thank you for the people of God. I thank you for your sustaining power. I'm praying, Lord, that you would grant us the grace to grow in love, to grow in understanding, to respond, Lord, with mercy, with compassion, with understanding, with grace, one toward another, so we could show the world that you live among us by our love for one another. I thank you for it, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. I hope to see you soon.